When everyday life is difficult, how do you daily maintain a kingdom perspective despite what circumstances are communicating to you?
Oh, I wouldn't survive a week if I didn't know how to feed myself on promises and testimonies. I mean, that's what I do. And worship, the whole thing of worship, of not bringing my problems into the environment of worship. Hmm. It's not that he doesn't want to hear it. It's just I can't see him through the eyes of just my, as the problem solver. Hmm. I've got to see him for who he is. Mm-hmm. And then turn to him with, God, I really need a breakthrough here. But then the promises, you know, I really try to record what he said to me in my life. I try to review them. You know, if I'm doubting or I'm in real trouble, I instinctively go to the Psalms, for example. If I'm facing something really hard, I'll just get alone. I'll open the Psalms. I'll just begin to read. And I may read 20 Psalms in one sitting, but I'm going to read till I really hear my voice. And that's what I do. And I've had situations that just wouldn't go away, mm-hmm. you know, and I would get comfort, but it would last for 20 minutes. So what I would do is I'd just get right back into the Psalms. I'd get right back into worship, and I would fight that fight, not face-to-face with the enemy as much as face-to-face with my own fears or doubts or whatever. And I would just feed my heart on promises, feed my heart on testimonies. This is what God did last time. This is what... You know, this is my history in God. Has God fixed this before? So,
yeah,
that's how it works for me.
Do you watch what you're watching at all? I mean, are you like you lessen your news intake, or do you change your news intake? Or
yes, absolutely.
So there's also the positive thing that you're doing as far as feasting on the promises and the testimony of the worship. They're also you're reducing the inflow of negative.
Yeah, I don't watch news much anymore, ever at all. It affects me too much. It's too easy for me to move into a political spirit and try to use
seem so.
What happens is you start using the tools of man to accomplish the purposes of God, and it just doesn't work that way. Yeah. You start thinking of what we need to do, and mm-hmm. it's not healthy for me. And I'm not saying it's wrong to watch it, but I have to be very guarded when I go in, mm-hmm. and be very intentional. And it's not just that; it's limit who you spend time with. Mm-hmm. You know, if you have family members or friends that are very negative and critical and sarcastic and whatever, well, limit your time. Yeah. Realize that your immune system is down. Mm-hmm. And don't hang around people with colds, you know, mm-hmm. spiritually speaking. Don't be in an environment where you're going to pick something up. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just wisdom to realize your own personal strength. The people in war, on the front lines of war, they restrict their focus. They only have a few concerns.
Yeah.
They don't care about car payments, house payments. They don't care about, they want ammunition. They want to keep their heads down. They want to know where their friends are.
Yeah.
You know, it's real simple. The back end of the battle, it's what's for dinner in the mess hall tent, what movie is showing Friday night, mm-hmm. completely different concerns. And it really, it's wisdom to know when I'm in the heat of a battle, just refine my focus and just concern myself with just a few things. So mm-hmm. that's wisdom, I think.
Yeah.